We are in the a church, Armenian, Catholic Armenian church. As we talk about before, Armenian community divided into mainly three parts: Apostolic Armenians, Protestant Armenians, and Catholic Armenians. At the beginning of the 1850s, Armenian community divided into mainly two parts: Apostolic and Protestant Armenians. But at the 1851, approximately 300 people, Armenian and Greek people, decided to establish a Catholic Armenian church, and they tried to get a permission from the Ottoman government for constructed a church building. At that time, the economic situation of the Armenian community, especially who believed the Catholic idea, didn't enough for constructed a church. For this reason, they contact with the French Empire, Napoleon III, then he give or support the some money for construction of this building. The construction of this building had start at the 1862, and the church opened the doors at 1868. At that time, all the churches in Antep, without apostolic church, had a sukkus. Also, Catholic Armenian or Catholic Greeks at that time established a school connected to this church. But in this school, the education in Turkish language, and also the priest of this church came from the Lebanon. Most of them, some of them, especially Franciscan monks or priests, the managed the worship or sermon of the religious sermon. But in 1886, the Armenian community connected this church didn't like the teaching system of the Franciscan monks. They decided to establish or education in Armenian language. And then the relation between the Franciscan monks or priests break, and the church priest is the came from Aleppo. Start to manage the religious ceremonies and also manage the school and educate the children of the community. The Armenian community in Antep, the Catholic community, were the minority at the their population. When the beginning of the 20th century, approximately less than 1,000. For this reason, you noticed this church is not big church, and the old church, the same old church, the pray is the on the ground, not chairs, not tables, and we can see the altar behind us. The priest or monks managed this pray. This church is continue his religious life up to 1915. As you know, at the 1915, Ottoman government decided to deport the Armenian community all of the Anatolia. Some of them deported Armenians are lucky, but especially in Antep, Catholic Armenian community are unlucky Armenian, since all of the community, member of the all of the community, lost their life during the deportation. And also, this is the interesting story. The priest of this church at that time, 1915, the Ottoman government military officer ordered that if you want, you can stay in Aleppo. But the priest said that when my community will go there, I have to go with them. Unfortunately, the Catholic community deported in the Derzor, desert of the Derzor, for some massacres, some effects of the starvation and disease. All the community lost their life, and the priest also. At the end of the World War One, and during the between the World War One, between 1915 and 1918, this church closed its doors. It was used as an empty building. Until the end of the World War, Armenian community, survived Armenian community, returned to their motherland. But unfortunately, Armenian Catholics couldn't return, since, as I said, all of them, they lost. For this reason, this building only used approximately as a church 70 years. But after Turkish Republic established, this area used as the some textile fabric area concept some. At the 1925 or 26, this church started to use as a warehouse of the a textile factory. This usage used as a approximately middle of the 1980s. And then at that time, middle of the 1980s, this factory is not useful for the owner. It was closed. And also at that time, the area, the building was here, covered by the high walls. For this reason, nobody cannot notice a building, this building, and they don't know there was a church, according to formal history. But at 1987, a man came from America. He is originally from Antep. Noticed this church. He wanted to visit and take a picture. This building. Firstly, he can get a permission from the guard of the building. But at that time, manager noticed he take the photograph. He couldn't get a enough photograph. And no, at that time, between 1930s and 2005, nobody know. There was a building used as a church. 2005, the municipality decided to new road open the new road, then the wall, high wall is destroyed, and then all of the people who are dealing with the history of this city, they can notice this building. And also in the when you read the formal history of this building, they write that we investigate a church in this area. It's the unbelievable explanation, investigate, since this church, this building or church constructed this area approximately 100 years ago, and also some of the people know that there is a building, but they don't say anything about this building. After the 2005, the municipality decided to convert this building as a cultural center. It was used as a cultural center approximately 10 years. But after that, it was converted as a wedding ceremony building or area. Since this history of this building is very, very, we get not enough information. Yeah, I'm continuing. If researcher get the opportunity for the records of the friends, most probably they can reach the detailed information in this building. We don't know detailed information since during the deportation time, all the records are destroyed or lost by the effect of the deportation conditions. But during the French occupation period, I guess, most probably when the French army leave this area, most probably they collect some records for this building and this community. And also, there is an interesting situation. When the French army occupied this area, they didn't dealing with this building. This building is not directly, indirectly connected to the French, since it was constructed by the support of the Napoleon III. Maybe at that time the officer of the French army, they didn't have any information this area. For this reason, we cannot reach detailed information about this building. What happened before the World War I? But we know that after World War I, we can reach some detailed information. Maybe you noticed some inscription in that wall. It was written in Turkish, but it can tell the small information. But according to me, detailed information. Only one sentence, but explain the too much information. For this reason, I cannot detailed information about this building. Yeah, also during the restoration period, some paints, some pictures cleaned, raised by the restoration period. When I visited before restoration, I can see some paints at the altar and at the dome. But today, unfortunately, we cannot see. And this, for what reason this raising? made? It's the big question. It is the cover of the history, especially the Christian parts of the history tried to cover it by the government. But as I said, the Apostolic Church, we are happy, can see living, surviving of these buildings. Maybe I cannot say or forget, before World War I, this city had a seven church, and church building, some of the church building near the mosque. Christian community and Muslim community living together. Not perfectly peaceful situation, but they are, have a good relation between them. But we are grandson of the Muslim community, but we try to cover the Christian history of this city. Why? Since our grandfathers tried to establish a new state, and the aim of the state, purpose of the state, only Muslim, especially the Sunni Muslim community. Most probably this reason. We cannot understand or try to learn what happened before the Republic of Turkey in this city and the other city. The same situation we can see all of the Anatolia. If I get an opportunity to research at the, in France, Nubarian Library or French Army archives, we can find some answer for our questions. And also, as I said before, the Armenian community, this city, was written a book, History of Armenian, but unfortunately, at that book, no detailed information for the Catholic community, also Protestant community. They told about Apostolic community. This was show us the relation between the different community, not so good at that time. Also, it was continued today, most probably. But I hope someone will be able to find the detailed information for this building or other buildings in this city.